Hi, I'm Kalyan Karmakar and welcome to Foodocracy Kitchens, where I'm going to speak to you about some Goan food cooked out of Mumbai. You will expect it to be very common, but let me assure you that it's not easy to find Goan food commercially in Mumbai. It's pouring in Mumbai this afternoon and it reminds me of one afternoon in Goa where it was pouring and we reached our hotel. We were not very happy with the place we were staying. Everything was shot and then we found this place called Infanteria, which my wife told me we should go to because she'd gone there earlier doing a shoot with her colleague and boss at that time, Kumuda Rao. And we went there and I think that is when we fell in love with Goan food that afternoon, when we had the roast tongue and the prawn chili fry and the mussel chili fry and the pork chili fry and everything. Goan food as in Goan Catholic food. And today I'm going to speak to you about the Goan Pui, which is a home chef endeavor by Aaron De Silva from Mumbai's Mahi. But before that, a bit of Goan food and me. My first interaction with Goan food was at Manuri Bell when I just moved into Mumbai for an office training. And I was introduced to Goan sausage, and a gentleman called Hemant said that it's a bit like a pickle. Hemant Mehta, we tried it. And then I did make some trips to Goa, but those are office junkets at luxury hotels and then our honeymoon. And those sort of meals are more about butter paneer and veg au gratin and maybe sausages at the buffet, but not really about Goan food. Then after much hunting, we found New Martin Hotel at Colaba, which later I learned is not Goan owned, but Mangalorean owned. But we fell in love with the Goan sausage chili fry over there, the pork vindaloo and the sorpotel, and of course the beef steak fry with chili and onions, which is done with buffalo meat. Then that Infanteria afternoon happened, and I think that's when we really fell in love with Goan food and the Goan Catholic food, and we kept going back and discovering all of that. And then I came across the Goan Pui page by Aaron De Silva while we were judging for the home chefies. And let me tell you, most of the judges were drooling when they saw it. And it's no wonder that he won in the best street food from home category with his interpretations of Goan food. I wanted to place an order. It's difficult because Aaron does everything himself. He used to work in the Lord of the Drinks as a manager. And then the pandemic happened, didn't know what to do. He always loved to cook. His father, whom he lost at an early age, loved to cook and he remembers those things. He took recipes from his maternal grandmother and other relatives. I'm shouting because it's pouring outside and this is just the perfect menu for this. So Aaron started the Goan Pui after the lockdown to get some sanity in life, and he was cooking and people loved it, and he started taking orders, and now he's completely sold out. So there's a longer waiting line to order with him than it was to watch with Amitabh Bachchan movies in the 80s and 90s. I'm thinking of Shahenshah, which I tried to see. And then his cousin, Annabelle, who's a friend of ours, so she helped us place an order. And let's see what's come. So Mumbai has pav, and this is the poi. So this is what is named after, the Goan poi. So all of these are Portuguese legacy and Portuguese breads. In Goa, they're made in wood-fired ovens. Aaron hopes to get one someday. He says it'll be heaven when he does. And he makes it, and it's with husk on top and it's whole grains and so on. You should always like slightly warm it when you have poi. And in fact, poi is something which you often get on the streets of Goa with chorizo poi and so on. So that's why he won in the best street food category. And then these are Goan potato chops. So Kenaz and I love them. You know, we live in Bandra and we've had mutton potato chops and candies, and then we've had buff potato chops which you get at the cold storages like Jude's and so on, made by local ladies. In Infanteria, we've had the beef croquettes, which is slightly different. But this is Aaron's steak, I believe. It's a chorizo potato chop. So it's a sort of a panko crust on top. Traditionally, it's more breadcrumb. And then the outer coating is potato. And then he's put in Goan chorizo and sausage, which he sources from Goa. Now, how can I continue shooting this without starting to eat? And it's unfair to make Kenaz shoot this as well. When I'm sure she wants this. This is mackerel rechard. And what Aaron has done is he's deboned it and butterflied it. And rechard is again a Portuguese origin chili paste or paste. It's also referred to sometimes as peri peri. They're similar school, and it's with mackerel, which in Mumbai we call bhangra. And then there is the Goan pulao, which is always had on festive occasions with sopatel and so on. It reminds me a bit of the Bengali pulao, and then you put sausages in this and it becomes a churis pulao, which I absolutely love and keep going back to Martin's in Goa for. And finally, the dish which made us fall in love, made Kainaz and me fall in love with Goa and its food, which is roast tongue. So when we had it in Infanteria, and this is Aaron's version. And the beautiful thing about tongue is when it's done well, it's very tender, very juicy, very succulent. But in the Indian version, like the Goan version, there's also the kick of masala. And let me just show you how tender it is. How tender. Like in Bengali, we'd call this tultule. So that is all the food. So, okay, now I need to go. This is like too fabulous. And good on you, Aaron, man, for your lockdown baby, and wish you all the best. And thanks a lot, Annabelle, for helping me break the queue and get all.